Turborepo 1.8 is here just as we're crossing over 1 million weekly downloads on NPM. The new features in this update are great for adding even more control and more flexibility to your code base. And in particular, we're thinking that large teams are going to benefit a lot from this update. Let's take a look. Now, the first thing we need to do, of course, is to upgrade to 1.8. It looks like I still have Turbo 1.4 there, and my Turbo JSON is using some of the syntax from that version. With 1.8, we've introduced a new code mod, npx at turbo/codemod migrate. What this will do is it will automatically run whatever code mods that you need to get from the current version you're on to the latest version of Turbo. I'll go ahead and run this command, and we'll see that we're asked for our monorepo root. We'll see some terminal output, but I'll walk through the changes in my editor instead. The Turbo version has been changed to 1.8 as we were hoping for. And over here in our Turbo JSON, we're gonna see some changes. Specifically, we've dropped the bling identifier for environment variables in favor of the property keys, env and global env. Additionally, our output keys have changed since you'll need to be explicit about them since the 1.7 version. Now that we have Turbo 1.8 installed, we can go ahead and look at these cool new features. The first feature we'll look at is automatic workspace scoping. So if I'm using Global Turbo, I can go ahead and run Turbo build. We'll see that we're hitting the cache for two of our builds, web and docs. But let's say I'm on the web team. Let's say I only care about working with the build for that web project. I can go ahead and cd into the project directory, and I can go ahead and run Turbo build again, and you'll see that we're only going to hit one cache. This is Turbo focusing on that web folder using under the hood --filter. You just don't have to worry about doing it yourself. So if I go ahead and scroll and look at the logs, we will see only the web build is running. The second great feature in this release is workspace configurations. You might notice right above my head here, I have turbo.json in my web directory. That's right, you can now nest Turbo JSONs into the workspaces where you want to define custom configurations for those projects and packages. As an example, the nested JSON that I have on the right here in my editor, I'm setting hash only specifically for the web project. So if I go ahead and run Turbo build again, we're gonna end up seeing that I hit cache for that docs build, but we're only going to output the hash for the web build. This has another super nice implication, higher cache hits. So for instance, in the past, we only had a root configuration, and anytime we made a change to the root configuration, we were invalidating all the caches across our monorepo. So for instance, if I changed in our root to errors only, we would be invalidating all of the caches. So a run on Turbo build here again, we would get a new build for docs, a new build for web, linters would have to rerun completely. But now if you only change the nested Turbo JSON, you're only affecting the workspace that you change. So for instance, you can see here that I just got zero caches. Output mode, I'm gonna leave that as errors only, but I'm gonna move this to full for the nested Turbo JSON, and we should see that if I go ahead and run Turbo build, we are going to see that only that build for the web is affected. We still hit cache for the rest of my monorepo. This means that the team that is dedicated to that web project can focus on their configuration in their workspace. And additionally, if they make changes and they need something to be different about their builds, they're not gonna affect the rest of the monorepo now. We look forward to hearing your feedback about this release. For more, visit turbo.build/repo or check the description below.